So what happens when you take a 15-year-old cult favorite about a perfectly lovable demon child born of fire and reboot it with an R rating?
Find out on this episode of Alternate Ending when we review H.E. Double Hockey Sticks, Boy.
Here, it's okay to say hell on here.
Hey man, the movie may be an R rating, but we keep it clean here.
Tune in, tune in, tune in to Alternate Ending now.
Welcome to Alternate Ending. We're discovering good movies, one bad movie at a time. I'm film school dropout Robert Jarosinski.
And I'm the casual moviegoer, Carrie Jarosinski.
And while we have different backgrounds and perspectives on movies, our goal is always the same. To help you navigate the cinema world, to determine if you should spend big bucks on a flick rushing to theaters, wait for it to come out on streaming, or skip it altogether.
This episode, we're talking about Hellboy, which is a reboot of the Guillermo del Toro-directed 2004 feature Hellboy and 2008 Hellboy 2, The Golden Army, starring the one and only Ron Perlman. Based on the 1993 Dark Horse comic series, conjured from the mind of writer Mike Mignola, we're once again brought the origin story of Hellboy, only this time, director Neil Marshall brings us a much darker backstory that easily earns the R rating. The first two Hellboys brought in $100 million in 2004 on a $66 million budget, and $160 million in 2008 on an $85 million budget. While those figures are solid performances, it was a bit surprising that a reboot was something audiences were clamoring for, especially only after 11 years.
The plot for this Hellboy centers around Arthurian mythology, where a powerful sorceress named Nimue, played by Mila Jovovich, is about to unleash evil all over the world, but ultimately is defeated by King Arthur and Merlin. Fast forward to present day in the Bureau for Paranormal Research and Defense, or BPRD for short, led by Professor Broom, played by Ian McShane, is working to keep law and order from all things that go bump in the night. Broom's main enforcer is none other than the title character Hellboy, played by David Harbour, who you might recognize, or not, given the ton of makeup he's under, as the sheriff from Stranger Things. As in the original Hellboy, the backstory is that Broom adopted Hellboy following a botched Nazi ritual led by Rasputin. While originally meant to be a force for evil, Hellboy works with the BPRD, protecting humans against his own kind.
So let me get this straight. We have a blood queen named Nimue, King Arthur, Merlin, Nazis and Hellboy. Am I missing anything?
Oh, and Baba Yaga.
Baba Yaga? Oh, yes. How could I forget that?
A larger force is at play, looking to bring Nimue back so she can fulfill her destiny of unleashing evil on the world. But not if Hellboy and his ragtag group can stop her. Care, what did you think of Hellboy?
Well, if you remember, you actually introduced me to Hellboy back in 2008 on one of our first dates, which at the time I remember thinking was a definite red flag. And while I don't remember a ton about it, my main memory of it was that I didn't hate it, and I guess I continued to date you afterwards. So I thought maybe with the newly released Hellboy that I would be pleasantly surprised, which I now have found to be a giant misinformed lie to myself. The highlights for me were there was this character named Alice, played by Sasha Lane, and I happen to really like the name Alice. And yeah, that's about sums it up.
Hey! I'm on your side!
Sorry.
The lowlights for me were, and I don't really know where to begin here, but it is super gruesome. And I'm not super skittish by any means, but this is like, oh, hey, there's a colon laying over there. And oh, let's watch close-up shots of pedestrians being ripped in half. And I won't spoil, but it crosses the line into some kid gore, and I just don't really have a tolerance for that. Second, it's a genre mashup in a way that doesn't work. It's a comedic superhero meets horror, meets supernatural, meets terrible, and it just doesn't seem that it knows what it wants to be. And overall, there weren't really any performances that you'd say were great, or even really good. And the relationships and comedic timing just falls flat. And, oh gosh, there's this scene with Hellboy and that Baba Gaga lady that you were talking about. It literally made me want to burn my eyeballs out. And I'll just cut myself off there because there's just so much more wrong to discuss.
And you're f***ing nuts!
I absolutely recommend avoiding this movie at all costs. It's actively bad in almost every aspect that I can possibly think of. I give Hellboy 1 star. And in good faith, I could never recommend that you spend your time or money on this. So based on that, you love it, Rob?
Well, going into the original Hellboy in 2004, I was skeptical of the absurd-looking anti-hero. But after seeing the visual splendor of Del Toro and fantastic performance by Perlman, I was all in on the sequel. I was hesitant with the reboot, but 11 years later, could I use some more Hellboy in my life? Highlights for me were Mila Jovovich. This is the first time I've seen her play a straight-up villainess, and I enjoyed watching her have fun with it. But sadly, like, you care, that's one of the only highlights that I actually had. Lowlights for me were, first, CGI. I understand that they were working with a significantly smaller budget than the originals, with only 50 million bucks, but if you can't make it well, don't make it at all.
Okay.
Second, Hellboy. This is no knock to David Harbour, but I could not suspend my disbelief. It looked like a guy in a lot of bad prosthetics and makeup. Despite the original being 11 years old, when I saw Hellboy, I bought it. Third, the pointless R rating. The movie lets you know it's an R rating right out of the gate. They were likely trying to capitalize on the success of movies like Deadpool and Logan, but there's a point in which gore is gratuitous and just not pleasant to watch. Beyond that, while I can see Hellboy speaking with a potty mouth, the foul language was forced. In the end, could I use more Hellboy in my life? The answer is hell no. I give Hellboy a generous 2 stars and suggest catching it on streaming if you're looking for 2 hours to pass the time.
Well, we love hearing from everyone, so share your thoughts on Hellboy with us. We have other videos like this one that we'd love for you to check out.
And be sure to check back regularly to make sure you don't miss out on our movie reviews, trailer reactions, and live shows. If you want more details about all the stuff we're up to, including weekly movie giveaways, head to our website, alternateending.com. We'll catch you next time.
Tune in.